Okay, everyone, we're going to get started with the awards program. Hello again. If everyone could take their seats so we could start the awards program. Hello? Hello, everyone. Hello, I'm up here. Yeah. Dr. Sacchetti said there's going to be a test. So you all have to pay attention. Okay, everyone. Welcome. We're going to start the awards program. I'd like to introduce Nancy Kelly Goodstein, Acting Director of the Office of EMS, to give her welcoming remarks for tonight's program.
Don't worry, that table, I paid for that part. We're good. The mission of EMS is simple: provide state-of-the-art medical care to our patients and ensure that they arrive safely at the best possible hospital to continue their care. It has been and always will be about the patients we serve. And as Commissioner Bennett mentioned earlier tonight, the 911 system in New Jersey had 1.8 million calls for medical assistance. That's a phenomenal number. In order to serve our patients better, a number of initiatives have been put into practice. Guidelines for recognizing, treating, and transporting patients suffering from stroke, heart attack, trauma are all in place and put into practice every day. The New Jersey EMS Task Force, comprised of 60 agencies and over 200 individuals, who time and again respond statewide when their specialized education and equipment are needed. Most recently, the terrible train crash in Hoboken in September. The County Emergency Medical Services coordinators tirelessly serve both their respective counties and the state during both planned and large-scale events, as well as unexpected incidents that tax the local EMS agencies to their limits. We hear a great deal about meeting nationally recognized standards. We at the department are on our way to becoming accredited by the Public Health Accreditation Board. On the screen behind me shortly, you'll see the names of New Jersey EMS agencies that have met national standards for operation, education, and/or dispatching. Please take a moment to join me in recognizing their efforts. So much time and energy goes into becoming a competent EMS provider. Many sacrifices are made with time away from family and friends. Will all those in the audience tonight who are active providers of EMS stand to be recognized? Now, those of you, this is part of your test that Dr. Sacchetti alluded to a little bit before. For those of you that just stood up, when you go home, I want you to thank those who support you, because for without them, you might not be able to be an EMS provider. In addition to the nominees and their family and friends, we've also got some guests I'd like to introduce. Dr. Marilyn Franchin, today's keynote speaker from the Paris Fire Brigade. Dr. Onesia Bishop, the director of our public health laboratory. And I think somewhere out there is Brendan McCluskey, who is the director of emergency preparedness and operations. We've got from the New Jersey State Police, Lieutenant John Quinlan. To the members of the Honor Guard and our talented vocalist, Kim Remy. This event is co-sponsored with the New Jersey EMS Council. The chair of the council, who you're used to seeing if you've been in EMS in New Jersey for more than a week or two, is Mickey McCabe, who is home tonight recovering from his double lung transplant. Mickey, I know you're watching, and we will be done by 10 o'clock, I promise. We have a number of advisory councils, and I don't know that all the leadership is here, but if they are, please stand to be recognized. We've got the Mobile Intensive Care Advisory Council, Dr. Bill Wang, Air Medical, Dr. Brett Greenfield, EMS for Children, Al Sacchetti, EMT Training Fund, Dr. Stephen Vetrano. Will all the members of our advisory councils, a round of applause to all of you. For their very dedicated time spent and commitment to the outstanding contributions to this year's Sim Games, we have Gomard, and I'm not mispronouncing this, it's Antony Gurney, Jennifer McCarthy, Dr. Joseph Katura, and Dr. Michael Passafaro, our talented cast of actors, and all the behind-the-scenes volunteers who help bring our games to life. Thank you very much. To Terry, Candace, Eric, and Tim, outstanding job. Good luck topping this next year. And to the planners, who without them we wouldn't be able to host this evening, we thank them very much. Almost my last remark, so hang in there. Will the members of the OEMS team please stand? It is through all of their efforts that tonight and the past several days have happened, as well as the work of OEMS every day. So when you're looking for your card, can't find your CEUs, have to get your CEU classes approved, need to know where the medic exam is, and all that other stuff, these are the folks that make that happen. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Al Sacchetti as our MC for this evening.
It's always nice to do anything that Nancy's associated with. In particular, it's kind of interesting that if you look at OEMS in New Jersey and all of you guys, you never really care about meeting the standards of care. You guys are really more about setting the standards of care for others. And I'm really lucky. I get to go around the country a lot, and people always come up to me with, you know, really wonderful comments about either things they've heard about New Jersey or actually experiences they've had with you folks. So realistically, it's really, really nice and very, very honored to be able to walk around the country and say I'm from New Jersey. The other thing that's really nice is to get to give the awards I give. I get to do the Outstanding EMS Action by a Youth. And each year I'm blown away by the activity of these kids. This year the first award goes to Christian Pineda. On August 8th, 2015, Carlos Pineda fell a distance of about 25 feet out of a tree stand. He suffered multiple traumatic injuries, including a fractured wrist, fractured ribs, fractured arms, broken ribs, a lacerated liver and pancreas, and fractures to the eye orbit. If it weren't for his son Christian, Mr. Pineda probably wouldn't have survived to be here tonight. Prior to this event, Christian had received training in the first aid and is a certified lifeguard. When his father needed help, he applied the knowledge he learned from the training to save his father's life. Mr. Pineda stated, "I never thought that the life-saving skills my son received would be used on me." Mr. Pineda recalls his son stating his name, telling him to breathe, and telling him to hold on. Christian assisted his father with basic first aid and directed the New Jersey State Police, BLS, and paramedics to his location. Christian, your father wants to know that he is forever grateful, and so are we. Please join me in congratulating Christian Pineda as a recipient for the Outstanding EMS by a Youth Award. Christian, come on up. The next Outstanding EMS Award by a youth goes to Skylar Ruff. Skylar, we heard a little bit about you earlier, but we're going to talk about it again. On May 15th, 2016, Skylar's grandfather was eating when a piece of chicken became lodged in his throat and he began to choke. His daughter, Allison, began abdominal thrust, but to no avail, and her father became unconscious. That's when 14-year-old Skylar recognized that her grandfather now needed CPR and began compressions. During the compressions, the obstruction was expelled and her grandfather began to breathe on his own and regain consciousness even prior to the EMS arrival. Skylar's quick reaction and knowledge of using CPR in this situation clearly saved her grandfather's life. In her nomination for this award, the nomination stated that Skylar had made Gloucester Township EMS, Gloucester Township Police, her community, and her family extremely proud, and we are proud of you as well. In recognition of her brave actions, this year's Outstanding EMS Action by a Youth goes to Skylar Ruff. Come on up here, Skylar. All right, we're going to move on to the Outstanding EMS Safety Award. This year, the award goes to On-Time Transport. Safety in Motion is a safety program focused on one team, one mission to prevent incidents before they occur. The program focuses on driver behavior, including no texting while driving, and maintaining safe distances from vehicles to surveillance of good safety behavior, implementation of the equipment to prevent back injuries, and the promotion of a healthy lifestyle for all employees. Some of the examples Safeties in Motion program includes are implementation of the Street Eagle driver behavior modification tool. It's installed on all 128 vehicles and has improved driving habits of employees based on a computerized report card. In addition, they have the Digital Ally camera program to review accidents and incidents and to recognize employees employing safe and efficient ways while working. The employees are to be engaged in the 3-second rule to maintain a safe following distance when driving, and implementation of the how low can you go mantra, which indicates that the center of gravity of a stretcher should be as low as possible without having the crew members bend to transport the patient. The culture of safety of this agency begins at orientation and continues each and every day. The recipient is dedicated to ensuring that the staff have the tools and personnel to maintain the growing safety program already implemented. For their dedication and commitment to the culture of safety, the Outstanding EMS Safety Award goes to On-Time Transport. All right, it is now my honor to introduce Dr. Terry Clancy from the Office of EMS to present the next series of awards.
The next award is Outstanding EMS Call. On April 14, 2016, several Middlesex County agencies would join forces and respond to a serious motor vehicle accident involving four National Guardsmen that occurred on the New Jersey Turnpike. At about 2:45 in the afternoon, a U.S. Army Humvee carrying four soldiers overturned. Two of the four soldiers were trapped under the overturned Humvee, while the other two were out of the vehicle. Recognizing that the injuries met ALS criteria, BLS responders requested ground ALS, North Star, and South Star. Crews from multiple jurisdictions worked to free the two soldiers trapped. Recognizing the severity of one soldier whose leg was amputated during the accident, a commercial tourniquet was successfully applied and the missing limb was put on ice and airlifted with the soldier to the trauma center at Robert Wood Johnson. A second soldier had airway compromise, which needed to be stabilized prior to being airlifted by a second helicopter to Robert Wood Johnson Trauma Center. All four soldiers survived their injuries. The actions, collaboration, and the ability to efficiently and expeditiously provide quality pre-hospital emergency medical care were exemplified by all agencies who responded that day. The responders undoubtedly were honored to care for our military personnel who proudly and unselfishly serve our country every day. For their actions and utmost collaboration to take care of our own, the award for outstanding EMS call goes to Monroe Township Municipal Ambulance Service, Milltown Rescue Squad, Robert Wood Johnson Mobile Health Services, North Star, and South Star. Please come forward. The next award is Outstanding Hospital Emergency Department Nurse. The recipient this year was stated to exemplify grace under pressure. He was described as being able to handle chaos in the emergency department so much that it was as if an outsider were watching a well-choreographed ballet. This nurse has the uncanny ability to demonstrate many of the top qualities needed to be an outstanding nurse. Some attributes include excellent interpersonal skills, empathy, a good communicator, and respectful. He demonstrates compassion to patients, their respective families, and is respected by other healthcare professionals he encounters. He has been described as a leader, mentor, and educator. This year, the Outstanding Hospital Department Nurse Award goes to George Olszewski. The next award is Outstanding EMS Action by a Citizen. According to the American Heart Association, almost 90% of people who suffer out of hospital cardiac arrests die. CPR, especially if performed in the first few minutes of cardiac arrest, can double or triple a person's chance of survival. The above statistic surely applies to the coaches who responded to care for one of their own athletes. Ava, who collapsed during a track and field practice, went into cardiac arrest. When they found her, she was unresponsive and not breathing and no pulse. They immediately did what they have been trained to do. They called 911, provided chest compressions, and utilized the AED and defibrillated her. After she was defibrillated, she began to breathe on her own. They continued treating her until EMS personnel arrived and took over care. The doctor at the hospital told Ava's mother that the coaches saved her daughter's life. After speaking to Ava's mother, we know that the family, the school administration, board, and her community are forever grateful for the coaches' heroic actions. Is Ava and her family here? Okay. If they are, could you please come up? Okay. At this time, the award who goes for the Outstanding MS Action by a Citizen and to those who saved her life go to Dana Lavorne, Leo Donaldson, Terry Ivorone, Kaliki Ibia, Cassie Newman, and Tim White. Please come up to be honored. At this time, I'd like to introduce Dr. Stephen Vetrano to do the next series of awards.
Thank you, Terry. Okay, the next award, well, first of all, I just want to say it's an honor to be up here giving these out, and my hat's off to all of you as EMS providers. Thank you for all the work that you do on a daily basis. I couldn't be more happier to serve the New Jersey EMS system with all of you here. So this year's Outstanding EMS Physician Award, this year's recipient has demonstrated tireless support for the professional practice of emergency medical services in the state of New Jersey. As the medical director for Robert Wood Johnson University Hospital, New Brunswick, she is responsible for the clinical practice of 400 paramedics, EMTs, and nurses who comprise the mobile health service team. A true EMS physician, she doesn't limit her practice to within the four walls of the emergency department. She works alongside EMS providers to cover major events such as the Rutgers football games, Rutgers commencement ceremonies, and the Far Hills race meeting. She also carves time from her schedule for EMS office hours, giving providers the opportunity to discuss clinical questions in a calm, giving environment removed from the bustling emergency department. She is a researcher continuing the quest to improve pre-hospital cardiac arrest outcomes that has directly influenced the mobile health service care delivery model, saving lives and enabling a greater number of patients to walk out of the hospital after suffering cardiac arrest. What is harder to measure, but no less important, is the impact of her ongoing guidance to over 400 providers. She takes the time to sit down with providers who are struggling with their practice, directly contributing to the development of performance improvement plans when needed. Her standards are high, but she never loses sight of the human element of the delivery of care. This physician stands out in this peer group for her dedication, support, warmth, professionalism, and commitment to the practice of EMS. For her commitment to the emergency medical services and to those patients she provides care, this year's outstanding EMS physician goes to someone I am very happy to call a colleague, Dr. Colleen Donovan. All right, the next award will be for Outstanding First Responder. On August 26, 2016, a man jumped from a platform at the Secaucus train station onto the tracks. This is when this New Jersey Transit police officer climbed down from the platform at the terminal and pulled the man off the tracks to safety just seconds before an oncoming train was pulling in. Although he pulled the man to safety, it was not without a struggle. This officer saw the train rapidly approaching and in an instant said to himself, "I'm going to have to let this guy go, or he's going to take me with him." He then said to himself, "Let me give one more tug on hopes I can pull him through." New Jersey Transit riders were amazed by the officer's heroics and called him a true hero. For his heroic efforts and unselfingly putting his life in danger so that he may save another, this year's Outstanding First Responder goes to Police Officer Victor Ortiz of New Jersey Transit Police. The next award is for Outstanding EMT. This EMT has been in the field for over 30 years. He has dedicated his life to serving and educating his community and those around him, and has spent countless hours improving the services that his agencies offer to the communities he serves. He is actually one of my guys as a medical director. It was stated that he makes it his personal mission to ensure that each agency he is involved with becomes better each day. As the chief of the Clinton First Aid and Rescue Squad and the director of the Princeton First Aid and Rescue Squad, he has spent countless hours training others in EMS and rescue operations and has personally sacrificed so much that his communities are safer. He is the epitome of what a New Jersey EMT represents. For his commitment and dedication to patient care, educating his colleagues and the public at large, and his strive to improve the EMS system in its entirety, this year's Outstanding EMT goes to one of my colleagues, Frank Setnicki. I would now like to introduce Tim Saplacki, Data Manager from the Office of Emergency Medical Services.
Good evening. Outstanding ALS SCT Nurse. This recipient has been a valuable member of his specialty care transport team for over a decade. He provides interfacility transport at all levels and skillfully provides critical and acute care to patients from pediatrics to end of life. He is committed to patient care and quality improvement. He also plays a major role in orienting nurses in the SETU and the in role in bettering his staff. His nursing excellence within critical care, transport, and community is the foundation for all to model. For his commitment to excellence and quality improvement and patient care, this year's outstanding ALS SCT nurse goes to Matthew Mikorski. Outstanding paramedic. This paramedic started her career in 1982 and has over 34 years providing care to countless patients. In 1988, she was one of the first female flight paramedics to join an endeavor that is now known as the GEMSTAR program. After 2 years of flying, she had converted back to the street and has been trailblazing the ground ever since. After decades, she has always been kept, always had the ability to maintain quality patient care, dedicates herself to the field of education, where she serves as an instructor for the paramedic science programs at Virtua. Her drive and determination as a mentor, an innovator, and has been an inspiration to all that cross her path, including myself. For her distinguished commitment to the dedication of patient care and her ability to be a true leader in EMS, this year's outstanding paramedic goes to Lorraine Russell. Outstanding Volunteer EMS Agency. This volunteer agency is a dedicated group of students who have provided quick response EMS service to the campus community. The agency has come a long way from a student clum who would run to calls and is now a division of the campus police within the college realm. These enthusiastic students truly love what they do. Their desire to learn is high, and the quality of care they provide and education they obtain for themselves is top-notch. The biggest challenge for this organization is turnover. As student volunteers, membership is constantly changing. However, that does not stop them from providing excellent care on a day-to-day basis. These students have become experienced EMS providers who further their careers in EMS, nursing, medicine, and beyond. For their dedication and perseverance in providing quality care to their fellow students within the campus community, this year's outstanding volunteer EMS agency goes to the College of New Jersey EMS. It's now my pleasure to introduce Candace Gardner, Education and Certification Manager for the Office of EMS.
Good evening. And the next award is the Outstanding EMS Agency. This agency has undergone organizational change over the past several years, and through this change has evolved as a true leader in EMS response. They not only respond to over 19,000 plus calls a year, but they are a major state asset that responds when called upon. As an agency of the New Jersey EMS Task Force, they have responded to multiple events throughout the state and currently is a lead agency in hazardous materials response, special operations, and rehab operations. This department has increased its response capabilities and is a host agency to one of the New Jersey EMS Task Force medical ambulance buses and a mass casualty response unit. Additionally, they have trained and outfitted all of their EMS and fire staff with special tactical equipment to ensure that an integrated response with law enforcement to an active shooter incident. Not only are they committed to 911 response and special operations, they have committed to education and quality improvement. This agency trains approximately 200 EMTs annually within their service and ensures all staff are competent to provide quality care in all of their calls and patients that they encounter. For their dedication and commitment to the City of Elizabeth and New Jersey residents at large, this year's Outstanding EMS Agency is Elizabeth Fire Department's EMS Division. The next award is the Outstanding EMS Educator. When looking for a model EMS educator, one needs to look no further than this individual. His drive, commitment, and passion to educate EMS professionals and beyond is unconditional. One of the national EMS education standards is to incorporate medical simulation into the classroom. The reasons are obvious. While textbooks, lectures, and skills labs have been the pillars of pre-hospital education, they fall short of teaching EMS providers how to think critically and make rapid decisions accurately. Creating an environment for students to critically think is one that is individual, clearly specializes in. As EMS evolves and becomes more complex, EMS educators must integrate simulation technology into integrated practice, and this awardee does just that. He connects with his students and does so with integrity, and it is clear that he has had a major impact on all those who have been benefited from participating in his simulation program. Lastly, he has been an integral part of the simulation games since its inception, and for that, your colleagues are forever grateful. It is my honor to announce Gary Ackerman is this year's Outstanding EMS Educator.
Thank you, Gary.
Outstanding EMS Administrator. Strong leadership is a quality that every organization seeks to attain. John Quincy Adams said that a leader leads by example, whether he intends to or not. Leadership is vital and oftentimes immeasurable in EMS. This year's awardee has been instrumental in the New Jersey EMS Task Force leader, educator, and tour chief. His knowledge and ultimate professional demeanor are characteristics that he exemplifies. He was described as going above and beyond when his community in need and his expertise have been invaluable. For your dedication, commitment, and leadership in EMS, this year's Outstanding EMS Administrator goes to Stephen Sakala. I would now like to introduce Eric Hicken, EMSC manager for the Office of EMS.
Good evening. Good evening. The next award is Outstanding Emergency Preparedness Achievement Award. Since 1997, this award has served as a task force leader for New Jersey Task Force One, Urban Search and Rescue. He has been the driving force behind the growth and development of this elite team. Under his guidance, it has grown from a few members to become a dedicated group of more than 280 highly trained individuals who function in one of several components, including rescue, medical, search, planning, logistics, communication, and swift water. It is under his leadership that effective April 2016, New Jersey Task Force One received FEMA designation. He has accompanied the team on multiple deployments, both in and out of state, including 9/11, when New Jersey Task Force One was one of the first USAR teams on site, continuously working for 10 days. He has responded to explosions, multiple parking decks and building collapses, as well as severe flooding events such as Katrina and Superstorm Sandy. While this award possesses the skills and expertise necessary to field a team of this magnitude, his real gift lies in the ability to attract, mentor, and train a diverse group of men and women to become a highly accomplished, extremely motivated team that truly functions as one. Whether it's for an exercise or a real-world event, he inspires us with his quiet courage and supreme faith that no matter what, New Jersey Task Force One will get the job done. For his dedication and commitment to the residents of New Jersey and beyond, this year's Outstanding Emergency Preparedness Achievement Award goes to James Riley. I would like to now introduce Anthony Gurney, Robert Mackey, and Jennifer McCarthy to present the Sim Game Awards.
Don't look into the disco lights. Hi. I don't know who thought it was a good idea to have the New Yorker speak at this, but that was probably a bad idea.
Nope.
Well, thank you everybody for coming. Thank for everybody who was at the Sim Games. A lot of enormous amount of work was gone into planning the Sim Games. There's a couple of groups that actually were not recognized. One was V.E. Ralph.
Woo! V.E.
They donated a lot of equipment to the Sim Games finals. And for those of you who watched the finals, it was pretty wild. Before I get to Gumard, another group that really wasn't kind of recognized was our two New Jersey State Troopers. Guys, stand up, please. This is the only time in my life I'm going to be able to tell a cop what to do. Get up. I think we all can agree that having them really enhanced our realism, really enhanced it and made it that much better, and it was really pretty great. And lastly, Gumard Scientific. They are the company that provided our mannequins. And I'll tell you, after a long time in simulation, we are working with some of the best mannequins there are in the world. Those things are unbelievable, and the people who worked with them will tell you that. So now, without further ado, I'm pretty sure you've been waiting for this. I'm going to introduce Jen McCarthy to get all the winners.
Yow.
We're going to start, obviously, with third place, starting with ALS. I don't know why there's no music. We really had a lot of music last night. Yes, exactly. ALS or BLS are we going with? Because I don't have a script, babe. Okay, so let's start with BLS. Third place, BLS. Okay, ALS, I'm sorry. Third place, ALS. The Valley Hospital, Todd McCoy and Mike McSoud. Come forward, you guys did a great job. Valley Hospital, where are you? Mike, you want to wait for 1 second? 1 second. The third place BLS is Hackensack Meridian Health, Pierre Haddad and Judith Santos. Great job. If you guys wanted a third place team picture, since you. And for second place this year, we have a special acknowledgement going out. It's a sponsored gift on behalf of the Mount Laurel EMS, and they're proud to present this year an engraved stethoscope to the second place winners of the Sim Games. And it's my honor to read the following passage. A member of the Mount Laurel EMS, a paramedic student, and a past competitor in the Sim Games, Katie. She was very passionate about EMS. She was in the process of completing her training to become a paramedic when she lost her battle with depression. A green stethoscope has been chosen in support of the Code Green campaign and its efforts to increase awareness of the mental health issues facing all of us as first responders and EMS providers. Whether you choose to use or display it as a reminder of placing second in this great accomplishment in the Sim Games, we hope its presence will help you raise awareness, more importantly, in mental health campaign and EMS. My hat goes off to the Mount Laurel EMS community for supporting this campaign. So without further ado, second place ALS, Fidney EMS, Randy Lee, and Kevin Ramdalyal. And for BLS, Jersey City Medical Center, Jessica Masterson and Heather Oliveira.
So there's the claret jug in golf. There's the Lombardi Trophy in the NFL, and there's the Stanley Cup in hockey. We're gonna call this one the Goumard Cup because this team was absolutely amazing. The first place ALS team in the New Jersey Sim Games for 2016's Capital Health EMS, Andrew Grandin, Megan Wichardowski. You can take the cup around and like drink out of it and stuff like that. But there is a guy with little white gloves. And first place, once again, another team that was just absolutely unbelievable. The first place BLS team in the 2016 New Jersey EMS Sim Games, McCabe Ambulance. Amber Henderson and Russell Kahn. On a personal note, I'd like to thank everybody who competed. Please give everybody who completed in the preliminaries and the finals a big round of applause. It was tough this year, really, really tough, and they shined.
I do want to make a side note. They get to keep the big ones for about 8 or 9 months for bragging rights, and then we bring them back next year, and their names will be engraved on it forever. Good job. I would now like to introduce Acting Director Nancy Kelly Goodstein from the Office of EMS.
We already heard Commissioner Bennett speak about the next recipient. He's been a tireless advocate for those falling victim to exposure to toxic substances or medication overdoses. He has served the population of New Jersey for more years than I think he'd like me to count, certainly in a public forum. always working for the seamless integration of the expertise and services of the New Jersey Poison and Information System, or NJPIES as we call it. He has provided countless updates on medical management of new or trending exposures, permitting both EMS and hospital emergency department staff to treat patients with the most up-to-date clinical protocols based on both New Jersey and national data. Nationwide, poisonings is one of the leading causes of unintentional death. That said, New Jersey has one of the lowest fatality rates for poisoning in the country, due in large part to the activities of NJPIES with prevention, surveillance, coupled with a very laser-sharp focus on the details in their medical director. Steve is enjoying his retirement. He declined to come here this evening because I think he knew we were going to do this to him. So I hope he's watching. And if you have occasion to cross his path, please congratulate him for all of us. Enjoy your retirement, Steve. Long and happy, healthy. The next award is presented in recognition of their vision, leadership, professionalism, commitment to excellence, public service, and dedication to the emergency medical services community. Their journey began in 1984 with a proposal to establish New Jersey's first hospital-based helicopter system. In 1988, the GEMSTAR program became operational, providing air medical coverage first for 16 hours a day and then later expanding to 24. Recognized by the National Transportation Safety Board for operational safety and system design, and also achieving national and international recognition for their flight program safety record, responding to over 21,000 medical missions. Dr. Joseph Hummel, medical director, Linda Whitworth, chief flight nurse, and the entire complement of air medical crew members are to be commended for the clinical care provided to those 21,000 patients, as well as their contributions to the GEMSTAR program. Please join me in recognizing SouthStar. So I find that the older I get, the larger the font I use. So this way I don't need the glasses in case I forget them. Okay, our next award category is for EMS Volunteer Lifetime Achievement Award. This year's awardee has volunteered his services to the residents of Avalon for over 50 years. He has served in every position during this time, from line officer to president, in which he served for over 20. He most often has the highest call volume each year and is on the forefront of fundraising for his agency. He was described as having excellent patient skills, handles emergencies with grace. He's a pillar in his community and is respected by all that he interacts with, including the Avon Fire Department, in which he is also a life member. I guess he was running out of things to do with his spare time. For his exemplary service and his commitment to serving others for over 50 years, this year's EMS Volunteer Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Bart Barry. Our next category, and the last for this evening, is EMS Career Lifetime Achievement Award. This awardee has been a state-certified EMT since 1979. He started his EMS service as a volunteer in Morristown, and then began his professional career. He has been a part of University Hospital since 1987. During his tenure at UH, he has Is he giving me a bad look? Oh, okay. He has served as EMT, rescue specialist, supervisor, and is currently the RAMS Special Operations Coordinator, which dispatches over 100,000 calls a year and handles statewide dispatch for the helicopter program and the New Jersey EMS Task Force. He serves on various statewide communications committee as a subject matter expert and is often called upon by many, including moi, for his communication expertise. He's responded to almost every major incident that has occurred within the state of New Jersey, from blackouts to Superstorm Sandy, to the Super Bowl, to the Pope's visit, as well as high-profile events out of state, notably to New York City on September 11th, where he spent countless hours searching for and recovering victims, as well as to Hurricane Katrina, where he established communications for rescue operations. Most recently, he traveled down to the Carolinas for that storm that avoided us, but unfortunately hit all of them. He has dedicated his life to the betterment of EMS service on both the state and national stages. For your tireless dedication and commitment to the residents of New Jersey and beyond, this year's EMS Career Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Joseph Berlew, Sr. Once again, our heartfelt congratulations to all the nominees, the family and friends that support them in their EMS lives. To the EMS professionals, thank you for all the good care that you continue to provide. And now please stay with us after the dinner and join us for a little bit more of a celebration. Please get home safely and good night.
Nobody move. So Dr. Joe Katura serves in our military, and he's getting ready to leave on his fourth deployment, I've just been told. He has committed the last 3-4 years to come in here lecturing, participating in the sim games as a judge. If we could just give him a big round of applause of appreciation and support. Thank you, Dr. Katura.
We're going to nap all the way until somebody with something will stop to the dog. That's just it.